Have been busy preparing for this storm, and we're joined now by BGE spokesman Rob Gould. And Rob, you guys have been making all kinds of preparations, including getting crews from out of town.
Yeah, we've actually requested 2,000 out-of-state utility workers. Typically, we would ask about 1,000 at this point. We've got good line of sight on about 1,300 of those folks. They're already en route from as far away as New Mexico, Texas, Louisiana, Oklahoma. And we'll bed them down and get them in place. They should all start arriving tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And we'll put them at one of four staging areas, M&T Bank Stadium, BWI, Timonium Fairgrounds, and Ripken Stadium. So the goal is to have them in place, ready to respond once the storm hits so they can begin restoration.
That's what you're doing. What can residents do ahead of the storm?
Yeah, do what I'm going to do today. Go home, make sure I'm taking all the stuff that's off the deck and try to put it away, make sure you don't have any projectiles that would be out there. But from a power situation, make sure that you have all your contingencies in place, especially if you have loved ones or yourself are dependent upon electricity for your mm-hmm. medical needs. Make sure you've got a backup plan. The basic things, you know, flashlight, portable radio, those types of things are important. If you do use a portable generator, make sure you move it away from the home. Not near windows or the garage, because those fumes can back up and become very deadly.
Earlier we gave some information about if you have limbs that look like they're need to be taken down, call you all?
Well, I think we're at a point now where that's a little impractical. we pretty much have been on a regular routine of tree trimming. Some customers love that, some customers don't. I think the ones that will not lose power as a result of our tree trimming effort will understand that that's a necessity. But at this point, the biggest thing they can do is grab our number, make sure they put it somewhere close that they can call it if they lose power. Until we have smart meters throughout the entire territory, which will be a great thing because mm-hmm. we'll know when we have an outage.
Right.
We won't know you have an outage this time. You need to call us and let us know.
Okay, preserving the food in your refrigerator and freezer. What do you have any tips there?
Yeah, I think once you start to, I mean, we're obviously not the ones to tell you about how to make the determination, but 12 hours, 24 hours, you're starting to get to that point where mm-hmm. it's not a good idea to eat the food that's in the fridge.
Can you adjust the temperature in your refrigerator?
Turn it up as cold as you can, make sure you've got that going. And obviously, if you don't need to open it, if you do lose power, you know, keep it closed. At the end of the day, this is going to be a long duration event. Mm-hmm. Customers need to prepare for that, and above all else, patience.
Call you if you have an allergy, but don't call you looking for ice. You don't do that anymore.
We don't do dry ice, and don't call us to get on the list for outages. We have customers that will actually do that. They'll call at the beginning of the storm just to get their name on a list. That's not
there's
the way
no
to
list.
Do it. No, there's no list.
Thanks, Rob. Good luck with everything.
Thanks.